Hey, welcome back to the channel, everyone. I received a question and a request from one of my viewers the other day that inspired me to create this video. Chinarello asked, I've just found the whole user task concept somewhat confusing. Is the user task part of the system or something the user does? And the user goes on to ask, I would like to see the system in its own lane and the user in its own lane. And so one of my favorite things to do as a practitioner is to engage with those who have questions, want to talk BPMN, how to apply it. And so for today's video, let's discuss user tasks and how you can apply them effectively for communicating your business process model. User tasks are just that. It's something the user does with the assistance of software, an application, or even equipment. In today's society, mobile applications are everywhere, and I'll use that to convey the user task. And really, if you think about it, it's that front end that we interact with on a daily basis when we're on our mobile apps. What we don't see is the back end. But are those user tasks? Let's walk through a process example here for our credit card payment process and talk specifics. So as a customer, we can use our credit card company's mobile application to make payments. On the screen, we represent that as that customer interface, where we can pull up our app, as you can see on the screen here, and make a payment, put in an amount, and submit. What we see is pretty straightforward. Our balance, ability to make payments, we can enter our details, and then we can submit. What we don't see is on the back end, how the credit card app processes that payment. What is occurring behind the scenes? We may get the results of these activities, but we don't necessarily see these activities. We only see that end result. And so in this case, in which we have, if we have sufficient funds, the payment is applied to our balance. Pretty straightforward. We'll see that result, but we don't apply it to the balance. So I consider this a service task. It's automated. On the flip side, if we don't have sufficient funds, we'll receive a notification. You know, the app on the back end will say, oh, you know, for whatever reason, you don't have funds or the payment didn't go through. And again, this is where we flip to say, from a user perspective or the customer perspective, we have these user task or tasks. In this case, I use a receive task just to indicate that the throw and catch concept, but for task. But on the user task, I can open my inbox and I can update my bank information. Again, interacting with that front end and then going back to my process to make a payment. And then hopefully everything's good there. A key note is those back-end tasks are not user tasks. Those back-end tasks are typically service, script task, business rule task, or message send and receive task. And in this example, I use the service task, and then I use the send task. So there you have it. A simple example of how you can use user tasks and apply them effectively to communicate your business process model.